Now, in this video, I will show the construction and working of eddy current dynamometer. Here I have the diagram. Eddy current dynamometer consists of rotor. Now, rotor is the shaft whose power we want to measure. It can be crankshaft or any other shaft, machine shaft, engine shaft, any shaft whose power is to be measured, that we are taking as the rotor. Next, here we are having stator. Stator is the stationary member. It is having number of poles, or we can say teeth. These stator poles, they are also called as teeth. Then DC supply is given to the stator. After that, we are having cooling water arrangement. In eddy current dynamometer, lot of heat is generated. So you need to cool the dynamometer. So for that, cooling water arrangement is provided. And then we are having this arm, which is directly connected to a pointer, which shows the amount of torque. And if we know the torque, we can use the formula to calculate power. So this was regarding the construction. Now how it works. The shaft which is rotating is acting as the rotor. We are supplying DC current to the stator, and when DC supply is given to stator, magnetic field is produced around the rotor, and once the rotor starts rotating, that magnetic field is cut, and once the magnetic field is cut, there is eddy current generated because of the loss of magnetic field. And when that eddy current is generated, at that instant the torque is measured with the help of torque arm and given to the pointer. So we can directly get the value of torque, and once we know the value of torque, we can calculate the power by using eddy current dynamometer. So as we have seen, in case of mechanical dynamometers, there friction was involved. Here there is no contact between rotor and stator, so the friction is reduced. So that is an advantage of eddy current dynamometer. Friction is absent. Next, these dynamometers, they are fast in operation. Then they are lighter in weight. But if we consider the disadvantage, they require external power supply. Then there is eddy current loss. There are chances of short circuiting. Lot of heat is generated. So these are some advantages, disadvantages, and I have shown the construction and working of eddy current dynamometer. I hope you all have understood this.